Good afternoon, I'm Faye Barker. The government has laid out a battle plan to tackle the spread of coronavirus following the rise of cases in the UK. 23 people are now known to have COVID-19 here. The latest case, a member of staff at an infant school in Berkshire. Care homes have to be extra vigilant. When I first arrived at this care home in Kent earlier, one of the first things I had to do was wash my hands really thoroughly for that 20 plus seconds. Plus, you can see the cleaning staff are also working extra hard.
No high fives from the tunnel at Anfield last night. Put your hands away was the message to fans from Liverpool manager Jurgen Klopp. The presence of any fans for the clash against Atletico Madrid had already been questioned, as fears over COVID-19 back in Spain has led other players into quarantine and matches suspended.
The Health Secretary has now confirmed a number of new measures which are planned to fight the coronavirus pandemic, saying Britain should be prepared for them to disrupt the lives of everyone. Matt Hancock said the elderly and vulnerable must be shielded and entire families could be asked to self-isolate in the coming weeks. The latest update on coronavirus cases is due soon, and it will be remarkable if the total number of deaths in British hospitals doesn't rise above 10,000. That grim milestone will include three more nurses who have died, even as the Prime Minister thanks the nurses and NHS staff who looked after him, saying he owes them his life. At Middlesex University, study and students have been replaced by the production of personal protective equipment for the NHS.
What does it mean to be able to help out in this way?
I have no shortage of staff volunteering to come in. I have about 70 people on the list waiting to have an opportunity to contribute to such a good cause.
The sound and sight of a time gone by for a hero of today.
Every day seemed to be a highlight. I mean, really, the amount of money that people have subscribed to this fund is absolutely enormous. Never in 100 years would you have anticipated a total that we got.
I must have left my house at 8 because I always do.
The life we used to lead in Lego and the changes we've all faced. ABBA's song The Day Before You Came proved to be the perfect soundtrack to a film about lockdown created by a family in lockdown in Teddington.
I think we're about a couple of weeks into isolation and it was feeling very strange, and obviously we had a lot more time on our hands. I guess it's just about the way that the world changed really quickly after lockdown. So that's a character who used to go to work every day and then suddenly he doesn't.
George Floyd, as he was arrested by police in Minneapolis on Monday after a report of forgery. But then, in disturbing footage, he's on the ground, a police officer kneeling on his neck.
Please, I can't breathe. Please, man.
There are more anti-racism protests planned in the UK this afternoon in a weekend of demonstrations supporting America's Black Lives Matter movement. The vast majority of British protests have been peaceful, but 14 police officers are recovering from injuries today after clashes near Downing Street yesterday.
The clapping that became a part of lockdown life to thank key workers, especially those in the NHS. Over 10 weeks, it was a chance for communities to come together when so much time has been spent apart. Dame Vera Lynn's power to connect the nation has been felt again while the country has been in crisis. The Queen, in a rare address to the nation in April, echoed the words from her famous song.
We will be with our families again. We will meet again.
Today is heading to be the hottest of the year so far, and already this lunchtime, the coast is filling up with people. But the draw of the sun can be a danger. In case you need a reminder, we are still in a pandemic.
There's enough distance between everyone else, so there's no real issues as such in terms of social distancing. Yeah, it absolutely seems fine. Yeah, it seems safe. Yeah.
Great.
How are you feeling about performing in this very glamorous car park?
This is very exciting. You know, we're not a drive-in country, but, you know, people say, what have comedians been doing in this time? And one thing we've not been doing is taking it as a hiatus. It could go one of two ways. It could be great, or it could be a case of standing at the drive-in, branded a fool. What will they say Monday at school?
And what will... I love that to the camera. And what will they say?
What will they say?
What will they say?
They'll look at me and say, what are you doing here? You're 50 years old. Get out.
Oh, Major Lindley, thank you so much.
Thank
Lovely
you.
To
Thanks
speak to you.
Me.
Good luck. Yes, so the whole thing is about staying entertained, but also staying safe.
Hi, guys. It's Betsy. I just really wanted to say thank you so much for the 1,000 subscribers.
Yeah, Betsy is a girl with big ideas and big ambition to spread positivity around the world.
We are feeling negative about this lockdown, even though it's getting a little better. So once again, I feel it's the best time to start. If the world feels positive, the world is positive.
Seven-year-old Timothy was concerned the Queen may need a distraction in lockdown, so he came up with a perfectly positive puzzle to send to her.
The word search is a happiness word search, and I thought that the happiness might cheer her up, so that's why.
Were you worried she might be a bit bored in lockdown and may need something to do?
Yeah, I was getting a bit worried that she might, because she's someone who runs the country and stuff, so she needs to be happy. And
the lights are on, but the doors remain closed, the sounds of entertainment silenced. Kirsty Hoyles was performing in West End musical Mamma Mia when all theatres had to close.
By the time I got to work and got to warm up at 20 to 7, we were closing for the evening and for the foreseeable future.
It's a similar story across the world of theatre, with the next act full of questions and uncertainty. Even when indoor performances can begin again with social distancing measures, the reality is most theatres will stay shut.
In a world of COVID-19, this means cast and crew are tested for the virus every working day. Results take up to an hour, and it's an added cost of around £60,000. But the belief is the time and money is worth spending.
Actually, I think we're very lucky that we have that knowledge that, you know, other people don't have. Like, I feel quite nice, confident going home to my family, knowing that I'm actually fine, even though I have been out to work and I have, you know, been around people.
Academics are calling for a delay in the return of students to universities to prevent the spread of coronavirus around the country. Well, let's get some more now on the implications of this. We can speak to Dr. Jennifer Roan from University College London. Dr. Roan, thanks for joining us this evening. What is your response to London now being put on the COVID lockdown watch list?
Well, I'm not surprised, given the fact that the per capita rates have gone up so much. This is not surprising. We've basically hit the threshold.
Overnight, police forces broke up a number of illegal gatherings in different parts of the country. Coronavirus cases are on the rise, and scientists are warning the new restrictions aren't enough to stop a second wave. England's Deputy Chief Medical Officer has warned we are at tipping point in the spread of COVID, similar to where we were in March. Professor Jonathan Van Tam says we must act now to prevent history repeating itself. Now to the front pages of the papers. The main picture in the Sunday Telegraph is of the Duke of Cambridge, who's become the first royal to give a TED talk. He's warned the planet is in peril due to climate change. The paper also reports that millions in the northwest will be ordered not to leave local areas as part of restrictions due to be announced tomorrow. The Sunday Mirror leads with accusations that ministers are dodging lockdowns in their own constituencies, while tighter restrictions are imposed in the north and local leaders will be given more control over the coronavirus test and trace system. That's according to the Sunday Times. That is it from us for now. I'll be back with all the very latest at 1:20. Until then, do have a very good morning. Bye-bye.